when my burdens, my heavy upon me. And the Lord saying, much to bear, the words that often come to mind, give it to God in prayer. I think of yesterday's misdeeds, when no one seems to be there. I recall the words that gave comfort, give it to God in prayer. I ask the Father to guide me, to ease all my worries and cares. In silence I hear the voice, give it to God in prayer. I'll face tomorrow with hope as life lessons I gladly share. It's never as dark as it seems when you give it to God in prayer. I don't know where she gets all these, but I love them. She's going to be back now, so Lord. Making some new friends this morning, I think. I hope we'll be friends. Good to see Diane and get to know her. I'm good to finally get to know Carol. She didn't know what to think this morning. I went back and sat down beside her. So she knows my nieces. She went to Woodlawn School. And my sister's kid went to Woodlawn School too. We learn stuff on Facebook. You don't get on it, do you? Sorry, don't get on Facebook?
No.
Shame on you. I'm trying awful hard to get off that. But sometimes I can get some pretty good information. But anyway, we're going to go to Luke 18 chapter, and I believe Charlie didn't take up all my time. But you know, when I quit preaching, when I went to Leatherwood, this started my lay speaking. Brother Tiny was there, if you don't know him, was a good one. I said, Brother Tiny, how did you know when to quit? He said, when God kept giving you much to say, shut down, don't make a fool of yourself. But when he gets through talking to me, to you, through me, I'm going to sit down. Is everybody having a good week? I pray they have. I see a few smiles. I ain't got everybody smiling yet. We're going to talk a little bit about prayer this morning. I need it today. I'm standing around here with some good people. I got a new one sitting back there, and I got to be careful about it. Mm-hmm. She might tell Miss Pat something. Goodness gracious. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Remember that. Men should always pray. Don't forget it. That's one of the most important things we have in our life, to ask our Heavenly Father to take care of us and not faint. Not lose faith, I should say. Saying, there was in a city, a judge which feared not God. You know any of them? I believe we got a few of them today. Neither did he regard man. I'm proud of y'all. I don't know what else to say. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him saying, avenge me of mine adversaries. Forgive me, Mr. Judge. But he said, I don't fear God. I don't fear man. I'm not gonna bother with you, woman. And he would not for a while, but afterwards he said within himself, though I fear not God, nor regard man. I feel sorry for him. Anybody that don't fear God, God don't want you to be afraid of him. There's ways to fear when you're not getting in damn trouble. We don't need to fear God. We need to live him. That man should have too. Yet because this widow troubled me, I will avenge her, lest by her continued coming, she wear me. I don't want that woman troubling me every day and want me to forgive her. So I'm going to go in and take care of it, and I'll forgive you. That's basically what he was saying. But thank what God is saying. And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said. And he shall not fear God. Avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long for them. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Now he's talking about God. God will avenge you speedily when it's in his will to answer your prayer. I know we have many sick. We have many friends living in sin. We have many friends and people we need God to talk to, and we pray for it. It will not happen until it's God's time. He will not heal your body until it's God's time. One day, friend, God's time is going to be in heaven. Your prayers all will be answered in his time. You will have a new body. Praise the Lord. All that sickness that we have, come. We'll have a new body. We won't have to worry about food. We won't have to worry about sleep. It's all been taken care of. You see, that's what he intended it to be when he made this whole world. But he done kicked Satan out. Satan come on down and took care of it in the Garden of Eden. And we're paying for it today. And we've got people in this world today that's, well, they're going to pray for it. Because to start with, God made heaven. Some people tell you he didn't do it. Some people tell you he made more than Adam and Eve before anything else. God made everything, and he's going to take care of us. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, he shall find faith on this earth. Think about it. When Jesus comes back the second time and he's on his way, he's going to find faith in everybody. Because everybody's going to be his people. Everybody's going to be here working for Jesus, for God, in the new heaven and the new earth. He's going to find faith because we're going to be there. My faith is going to be there, your faith is going to be there, and we're going to be able to say, praise you, God. Praise you, Jesus, for bringing me home. When he comes back, he shall find faith. And he spake this parable unto a certain which trusted in themselves, that they were righteous, and they despised others. Two men went up into the temple to pray. One, a Pharisee, you know what Pharisees was. The other was a publican, and you know what a publican is. He was a tax collector. Beat all the people out as much as he could, and all he could give. He went there to pray too. The Pharisee stood, and he prayed thus with himself. God, I thank thee that I am not as others. God, thank thee that I'm not like others. Well, they are extortioners. They're unjust, they're adulterers, and even as this publican over here. Then the publican, he said, I fast twice a week. I give tithe to all I possess. And the publican standing afar off, he wouldn't even lift up his eyes to heaven. So much as his eyes to heaven, but he smote his breast, saying, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Which one of those men did God like? The man that done all of these things, tithed, lived a life that he should be living? But Jesus said, I tell you, this man went down to his house, justified rather than the other, the publican. But the Lord, forgive me. Have mercy on me, a sinner. What did the Pharisee say? He didn't say anything about that, did he? They didn't ask the Lord to forgive them for anything. He just told them all this stuff and break it. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone that exalt himself shall be abased. And he that humble himself shall be exhausted. Any more powerful words? All we got to do is humble ourselves. God, have mercy on me, poor sinner. Jesus already took care of the cross too. All we got to do is believe on it. Have faith. Have in faith that the man that went to the cross and took care of our sin. And all we got to do is have mercy on it. Put your money in your pocket, but you can't buy it. Ain't that wonderful? What can you buy on this earth that's worth that free cross? I'm sure Brad is free because I couldn't buy it before. I don't believe many others could either. Because he said it's free. And they bought into him. Listen, they brought infants to him. That he would touch them. But when his disciples saw it, they rebuked him. His disciples. Hey, don't bother Jesus. Don't bother. Keep the children away from him. He might be resting or something. But then Jesus heard it. He said, but Jesus called unto them and said, suffer little children to come unto me. Forbid them not, for as such is the kingdom of God. What do we need to be like? Little children. What are those? You're innocent. You're innocent. We got to be innocent ourselves so we can seek the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child shall in no wise enter therein. You know, when you talk about these births, little children, maybe that's the heaven. We got to enter heaven as a child, innocent, without faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And a certain ruler asked him, saying, good master, what shall I do to inherit? Good master, what should I do to eternal life? And Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me good? There ain't nobody good but God. We need to remember that too. Nobody's good. We're not good. We try to be, but we're not. We're flesh. But we put Jesus in our heart. And every time we sin, we need to realize, Jesus is right here. How can I do that? Thou knowest the commandments. You know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not kill. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Honor thy father and thy mother. That troubled me for a long time. I got to honor my father. Then they said, honor him. But so many times you read where it says, go honor your father and mother. And you know why? Because God had come before everything. God is the one that we've got to honor before we honor anything else. And he said, all these, and this is rich man talking, all these I kept from my youth up. I've done everything. Now when Jesus heard these things, he said unto him, what could he like? What could he like? He done everything the commandments said. I kept them from my child up. You likest thou one thing, sell all that thou have, distributed into the poor, and thou shalt have treasures in heaven, and come and follow me. He didn't say you can't be rich. He didn't say you can't have a lot of things. But he's saying what you do with that is something that I don't like. Skip it away. Take care of the poor, take care of the needy. But mainly, come. come follow me. The main thing of all that, come follow me. They said the rich man had done all that, but he hadn't repented. He hadn't said, have mercy on me, a poor sinner. And that, if we don't do that, we're in trouble. And when he had heard this, he, the rich man, was very sorrowful, for he was very rich. He was sorry. Jesus told him to sell everything he had and give it away. Still, he walked away. How hardly shall they that have riches enter into the kingdom of God? It ain't what you got, it's what you know. Have everything in this world and you don't know God, you got nothing. You can't take a thing in this world. You know, we got streets of gold, right? This rich man, nearly passing away. He said, I know I can't take everything with me. What must I do? He said, I know, I'm going to sell everything I got for to buy gold. God likes gold, probably. Put his little bag, he passed away. He got up to see St. Peter and says, what do you got in that bag here? Oh, he said, I got gold. He said, why you bet that old cheap gold for? Don't you know we got streets of gold up here? We can't carry nothing with us and all that. For it is easier for a camel to go through the needle of thy than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. Depends on what we live. Depends on what we live. That rich man could love God and he'd be right there with us. And they that heard it said, who then can be saved? Who then can be saved? And he said, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. Man can't save us. I can preach my life away and I can't save you. I can encourage you. I can show you the way through the Bible. But I can't save you. But God can. God can. They're the only ones that can. Then poor old Peter. Then Peter said, lo, we left all and followed thee. We've left everything, Jesus, and we followed you. We're trying to do your will. And he said unto them, verily I say unto you, there is no man that has left house, or parents, or brother, or wife, or children, for the kingdom of God's sake, who shall not receive manifold more in the present time and in the world to come, life everlasting. I got a little bit ahead of myself a while ago, but I knew something was wrong, and he was telling me something was wrong when I was talking about him. Here he tells you. If we leave all of that stuff like Peter then said, we'll receive more on this earth than in heaven also. If we leave our mother and father, we're supposed to. The Bible tells us. Marry and cling to them. Leave. Raise another family. Who shall not receive manifold more in this present and this present time and in the world to come, life everlasting. Then he took unto him the 12. You know, he had his 12 disciples. I don't know if you realize that or not, but he put in their mind a block from things that they didn't need to know. And I believe he'll block our mind for things we don't need to know. If his disciples knew what he was fixing to tell y'all, they would go crazy, wouldn't they? What wouldn't they do? If they knew Jesus was on his way to the cross, to hang, to shed his blood, Peter, what, I don't tell them what Peter would have done. He would want his, he would want his loving child. But he kind of likes this way too. But we can't change Jesus' way, and Peter couldn't either. Then he took unto him the 12. He said unto them, behold, we go to Jerusalem. And all things that are written in the prophets concerning the Son of Man shall be accomplished. Did you read that? Did you read this Bible? Everything in this Bible that was prophesied about Jesus Christ, it had to be accomplished. There wasn't a way he could get out of it. He didn't want to. I'm glad he didn't want to. And it came to pass that he was come nigh to Jerusalem, or Jericho. A certain blind man sat by the way. He was begging. And hearing the multitude pass by, he asked, what's meant? Hey, what's going on out there in all that crowd? What are they doing? And they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. Ooh. And he cried, saying, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. The blind man had to know what Jesus could do. He knew to ask Jesus, have mercy on me. And they which went before rebuked him, that he should not hold, that he should hold his peace, but he could cry so much more. They could tell him, you ought to be quiet. Be quiet, man. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood and commanded him to be brought unto him. And when he was come near, and Jesus said, what wilt thou I should do unto you? Mr. Blind Man, what do you want me to do? Jesus already knew. He knew when he took off to Jericho that man would be sitting up for waiting on us. What do you want me to do? He's making magic. You're going to have to tell him what you want him to do too. You can't get out of that. And he said, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, see, all he done told the Lord what he wanted. And Jesus said unto him, receive thy sight. Thy faith is saved. The man had enough faith when he asked Jesus to blind that he did what he wanted. And that happened so many times. And immediately he received his sight. Followed by the word by God, and all of the people that saw, they gave praises to God. Oh God. We need to give praises to God every day, all the time, for all of the things that he done and all the things that he didn't do for me. I got to give him praise for it. Just because he don't give it to me when I want it, don't mean he ain't going to give it to me. Just because I'm supposed to be here 11 o'clock. Didn't mean I couldn't be 5 minutes later. That's all right. I sat up here, the man sitting back there. He should have been up here now. He was back there yakking. I know he was talking to the good looking man. But it wasn't you. What a day, what a glorious day we have. My friends, thank you for having me. Thank you all for coming out. I pray a blessing on you and each and every one that couldn't be here today. We're going to sing a song and the altar's going to be open. Anybody needs to